Hello everyone, Assalamualaikum. Here we'll see how to use provider state management for loading data from the network and do this beautiful animation. So take a look. We are loading data and the animation. Loading is done. We see the data. Well, to get started, you should install these three packages. Provider is for state management, HTTP for network request and loading data from network, and Flutter SpinKit for animation. Well, we'll use six steps to complete this process and get HTTP request or do HTTP request and update data using provider. Well, first we have to understand our data. So let's go ahead and see our data. You can go ahead and use any tool. You can use Postman or a browser, that's okay. And then go ahead and type in this URL. Well, it does a GET request and then it returns a JSON format, which is also more like a map. So here we have key value. So here we see that if we are going to make a model, we have to use these four fields. But to be simple, in this tutorial, we'll just use two fields, title and body in our model. So after having the basic understanding of our data, now we can make a data model. So let's go ahead and create a data model. So you can use Postman or any browser and type in this URL and then you will get a response like this. This is a GET request. Now here we do have some fields, user ID, ID, title, and body. So this is very important because this tells us how we are going to build our data model class using Dart. Here we see four fields, but for now we'll just use two fields over here, title and body. To build our data model class over here, I created a new file which is called datamodel.dart. So this is our data model class and here we have two fields, which is title and body, and as well as we have this constructor, and then we have this from JSON method because we'll pass the information used to this object and then we'll decode it and then we'll create a model, data model object using the decoded information over here. Well, after creating a data model, now we'll see step number three, which is creating a service class for loading our data from the network. So here I have created a Dart class, which is called a service class. So here is my service class. And over here I have a single method, which is called single post data. Over here, I'm using this HTTP package as HTTP. And after that, I'm using http.get method to get data from the server. And as you see over here, I'm using uri.parse to parse it to a string over here. And then I'm also passing the content type in the header. And after that, if the GET request is successful, we get the data from the server. And if we get the data from the server, we check the status code. And if the status code is 200, then we decode the body, and from the body, use that information to send it to from JSON, which in return it will create a data model object which it would be stored over here. Now see over here we are using this question mark because it might be null, okay? Because if we don't get 200, we are just simply doing print error. If we get 200, then we are returning the result, okay? And if we return if we can get the result, then we return it. But if we don't get the result, it'll simply over here return null. So that's why over here I'm saying that it could be null. And after creating the service class for loading data, next we'll create a data class with the change notifier. So here I have this data class which extends change notifier, because over here these are the data that we want to load and tell the UI that we have data. So here we created a post object using data model. And then we use this get single post data, which comes from this class over here. So we call it from our change notifier and put it in our object. And once it's loaded, it returns, then we notify using notify listeners so that our UI know we have new data incoming. After creating the data class, now we'll see how to create a provider with change notifier provider. Well, to do that, I have to come to my main method. So over here, I'll remove everything. And after removing everything, instead of returning a material app, we are returning change notifier provider. As you can see, we are passing context as well as we are creating the provider using data class. And our child is material app. Do see that here we don't have home yet, which we are going to create now. Well, next we'll see how to load and show the data. Well, to do that, in our main.dart over here, we'll create a new stateful class. So here we created a new stateful class, and this is a very basic class. And inside this, we have this initstate method, and inside this initstate method, we are creating an instance of this our data class so that we can get access to our get post data. Now do remember, get post data is coming from here where it loads the data from the server and put it in this object. So if we can call this method from here, we'd be able to load the data and as well as create an object of this data class using this provider. And then we'll create an instance of this provider, which is post model data, because we want to access the provider class, its data inside this build model. And then we'll replace this container with this scaffold. Now this is our scaffold, and here we have this app title. And then, as you see earlier, we created this post model data using this provider class, which is a provider of this data class. Because of this, we would be able to access the data in this data class, which has this post data, okay, or the data model using this post object. So over here, we created this object. Now, because we created this object, over here, we can access post and its title, post and its body. Now we go ahead and run our app, and we see that first we see the app bar and we see the data is loaded, and it takes a bit of time because it comes from the server. So now we'll do the animation. To do animation right here, over here, we do a conditional check using this post model object by referring to isLoading, which is over here. Do remember that when it tries to load, it is true. When the loading is done, it is false. So we'll use this conditional check. So here we would do post model. So here we have used post model dot loading, which refers to this variable over here. And if it is true, we show this animation inside this container. And if it is loaded, done, then is loading become false. So we fall back to this condition. Let's run it. So here we see beautiful animation and the data is loaded. Let's run it one more time. Here is our animation. It's running and our data. Thank you so much.